in Chicago.
Effectively immediately, teens must be accompanied by an adult any day of the week after 10 p.m. Dana Rebick is at Millennium Park. And Dana, have you seen any kids without an adult tonight?
We have seen some families walking by, but it is pretty quiet here tonight. I think the weather probably has something to do with that, also being Wednesday evening.
Dana said, you better leave me alone. Don't be having me out here diming people out. Hey there, besties. Thank you for stopping by. My name is MICHONDENYSE, and they is off the effing hook in Chicago. Now you say, what else is new? Exactly. I agree. However, the issue here is that we know that there's issues in Chicago. You say, do something, do something, do something. So then you have the mayor that says, okay, I'm going to do something. And what do you get? Pushback. We don't want that. We don't want that. That ain't right. Racism. White supremacy. Racism. What? Child, you cannot make this ish up.
So we're not starting with a blank piece of paper. We're tweaking what already exists.
Pushing back a citywide curfew from 11 to 10 p.m. for minors 17 and under that will be enforced 7 days a week. It had previously only applied to those 16 and under. Mayor Lori Lightfoot signed an executive order on the curfew change last week, but the...
Look who's out there. Look who's out there. Let's take a still by still, shall we?
Vote.
What are they doing?
Today makes it permanent.
Who's out there? Who's out there? They look young. They look like they under 18. They had a, if it was at 11 and they want to bring it down to 10, you should bring it at dusk. You should say dusk. That's what I vote for.
We have to set some sense of order.
You are absolutely right. You do have to do some sense of order. That's what the daggone mayor is trying to do. But then you got jackasses over here saying, no, don't do that. No, we can't do that. Why? Who wants to deal with all them kids? And then a policeman will come by and then they will, first of all, you don't need to have a bunch of kids outside that late away from their home, okay? That young. Because trust me, it's not just 16 and 17. They're younger than that. Then if the police come in and they have to do some sort of assembly, keeping them intact, then it's going to be some offensive touching. The policeman did this, policeman did that. God forbid if something happens as far as a GUN by the police, then that's going to be a whole different type of issue. Then let's not act like there could be some issues as far as females and males out here in the middle of the night doing whatever they're going to do under the age of 18. Like, it's nothing but a recipe for disaster. And lest we not forget, now that it's about to be warm, that makes everything triple than what it typically would be.
I understand that people want to do whatever it is that they want to do, but that's not how life is. We've got to set some standards.
No one has any standards. That's what half of the daggone problem is, because the parents aren't parenting their children. They're certainly not giving them any standards. They're not giving them any type of discipline. As I explained on a previous video, it's just out here to do what they want, because people just have babies and they just let them sit there and then they do whatever they want and then they have no kind of direction. That's why they're out here acting crazy, causing chaos everywhere, doing whatever they want, stealing. But how do you know what the hell it is that your kid is doing? Like, I understand after a certain period of time that you got to hope that whatever it is that you instilled in them, that they will do the right thing. But if you're just letting them be out there just because it's warm, just because it's the summertime, just because they want to be someplace that they ain't got no business being.
But if you, the parent, are not governing your children, then the curfew should be put on you.
I agree with Alderman Carrie Austin. That's what they need to do. You get caught, your parents get fined. Let's see if anybody does anything about that. You go ahead and bring your punk asses down here after 10 o'clock. That's fine. You better have some daggone ID. You ain't got no ID, your ass is going to jail. You better call your parents. As soon as your parent come down there, they better pay that daggone fee. It's the after curfew fee. Because you should be disciplining your damn kid. And if you're not and they run away, you better call and report them. Other than that, pay that fee. Do that 3 times a daggone week. We'll see if they do something about it at that point.
You the one that's allowing your child to rampage our city.
The ordinance passed 30-19. And while many aldermen...
It should have passed 49-0. F them 19 people.
...and supported it, many opposed the measure.
All this is reactive and a headline.
Alderman Andre Vasquez calls the move reactive and outdated. And
he also said it's racist.
doesn't feel it will help reduce gun violence in Chicago.
Because curfews don't work. What they do is they force people to go even further. All this does is it criminalizes children of color and further segregates our city.
And criminalizes children of color. How, Sway? How? I swear to you, I am so sick of hearing people talk about it's racist and racism because people are not parenting their own daggone children. You know why he don't care? His kids ain't down there. He live in some place in some suburb around a bunch of white people where he ain't got to worry about this because they got them daggone parks where he live. They got dog parks. They got a playground. They got all that type stuff. So that's why he don't give a damn. He is like angry about it too. You know why it seems like it's racist? Because it's all Negroes down there. How come all the Negroes are down there? I said it. Why? Where are their parents? How come they're not holding on to them? How come they're not telling them, you better bring your punk asses home and don't go down to that daggone park? Because if they call me to come get your punk ass, I'm going to leave you. I'm going to drop you off at the daggone fire station. They can take your punk ass because you don't listen. No, he don't know about that. He don't care about that. He just wants to be difficult, defiant, so he can act like he's trying to fight for the people. When you know daggone well, that's all that's down there causing all this daggone chaos because they ain't got no type of discipline. They ain't got nothing to do. They ain't got no place to go.
Some aldermen saying the new curfew won't work because the previous one wasn't enforced. At Millennium Park.
That's all right, because now we gonna enforce it. Enforce that sugar honey iced tea. Take them asses in. Guess what? When they continue to do this stuff and people stop coming to effing Chicago because they don't want to be dealing with this, because Millennium Park obviously is a tourist attraction, any other tourist attraction where they may be acting like jackasses and that starts to affect the city and they don't have no money, then what they going to do? Because them daggone kids ain't giving up no money and neither are their punk ass parents.
Park minors must be accompanied by someone 21 and older after 6 p.m. Thursday through Sunday. The rest of the week, teens must be out of the park by 10 p.m. Lightfoot making that move after 16-year-old Shondell Holliday was shot and killed near the Bean on May 14th.
Child shot and killed. What's he doing down there? Where was his mother and father? What time was he there? Nobody thinking about that. Ain't nobody talking about that. Nobody wants to sit up here and where's what's his name talking about curfews don't work. Curfews don't work. You had your punk ass at home. It works. If you had your parent with you, it would work. It's going to work better than not doing anything, but they would rather just not do anything. And then he's going to say, oh, it's reactive. Yes, it's reactive to the fact that some kid was killed. Like, this man don't give a damn because it's not his problem. That's what happens when you sit up here and you just let anybody get elected or you just go ahead by name recognition. You don't pay attention to who it is that's making these daggone laws and voting on the stuff that actually has something to do with your daggone communities. And they out here talking about, oh, it's reactive, it's racist. No. What are we doing about the child that was killed down at the daggone park?
It was prompted by scenes like this one, mobs of young people wreaking havoc around the Loop last night, kicking and throwing things at passing cars. 16-year-old Shondell Holliday was shot and killed during the mayhem, just steps from the Bean. And just about an hour ago, in a rare Sunday news conference, Police Superintendent David Brown addressed the violence and the city's plan to stop it.
Oh, no. Don't have any curfew. Let these banshees continue to run around, cause destruction, chaos, act crazy, sit up here and fight each other, mess up cars, vandalize, twerk. Of course, you know, they couldn't not go out without doing that. And it's all Negroes. So while that dumbass is trying to sit up here and talk about, oh, it messes with people of color, that's who's out there is the people of color. Get your damn kids.
Guys, whoever's on that person shot, it's a disregard over there. If you want that person shot, take it start over to Dearborn and Adams. Just go.
We need cars!
10-1, Dearborn and Adams.
So I guess they should just let them just be down here because they have nothing else to do. So because they have nothing to do, they should just let them be down here with this chaos, because there's not more important things that Chicago police could and should be doing than being down here babysitting a bunch of stupid ass kids.
Last night, madness in Millennium Park and throughout the loop. Police chatter suggests there was not enough officers to tackle this problem, while Superintendent Brown says officers did their job in enforcing the law. Proof of that, 30 arrests last night, 26 of them minors, 4 adults, including the shooter, a 16-year-old with a ghost gun that police believed killed 16-year-old Shondell Holiday. The mayhem spilled out of Millennium Park, the superintendent saying that they'll tackle that public space first, though, before continuing to other public spaces like North Avenue Beach, where we saw chaos spill over just a few days ago.
Millennium Park needs to be under control.
Now, right now at 9 o'clock, unaccompanied minors are banned from Millennium Park after 6 o'clock this evening, Thursday to Sunday. The move comes one day after a deadly shooting near the Bean.
Anyone under 18 will no longer be allowed in the park after 6 p.m. Thursdays through Sundays unless they have adult supervision. 16-year-old Shondell Holiday was shot and killed near the Bean around 7:30 Saturday night as hundreds of young people gathered downtown. Police say a 17-year-old is in custody in connection to his killing. And
17-year-old red-rummed a 16-year-old and all the other things that you've heard. All you see out here is, and that's why that dude is saying, oh, people of color, it's all that's out there. So if that's what it happens to be, then that's what it happens to be. So just because they're black, that means that they should be able to stay and do whatever the hell that they want. Is that what you're saying? We should just let them go? Let them continue to destruct? Goodbye.
Charges are pending. They tell us another 16-year-old was arrested nearby for having a ghost gun.
This new policy will...
What's a 16-year-old need a ghost gun for? What does a 16-year-old need a ghost gun for? That's crazy in itself. Man, I'm... You know what? Let me tell you something. I'll never need to go to Chicago. Goodbye. Now I guess I'll never see Millennium Park, where Oprah used to be. Get no daggone Chicago pizza. None of it. I don't give a damn. Y'all can have it. Sorry. Shout out to y'all that live in Chicago or anywhere in Illinois. It's a place that I don't need to go to. This is ridiculous. And the fact that there's people that's actually sitting up here trying to act like at minimum they're trying to do something and you want to thwart that? And then as soon as something happens over and over and over again, and then, like I said, the tourism gets pushed away, then you're just going to be like, I don't understand what happened. We need money. What happened to the money? We need money. Yeah. You've lost this tourist. There's no way I would go there. Mm-mm. Watching this mess? Ain't no way. Y'all can have it. Good luck to you. Good luck to you. And can't even come there and see Black Ink. Mm-mm. Sorry, Ryan, I'll have to see you on TV or when you come to a tattoo convention in Philadelphia or New York, because y'all can have it. So anyway, y'all, of course, let me know what you think. Sorry for anybody that live in Chicago. No tea, no shade. Y'all can have it. If you made it this far, I do appreciate you. Please consider subscribing to the channel. I will see you all in the next one.